Five-star salon here in Lido, Long Beach's number one salon. And now, let's give it up for Justin Shawshan, and he's going to do our weekly Long Beach High School Report. Take it away, Justin.
We are now present in the transition between the fall and winter season in high school sports. As tryouts are taking place for the next season, I thought that it would be a good time to recap on the previous season. Starting off with the Long Beach Boys Volleyball team, they finished the season with a record of 12 wins and 4 losses. They made it all the way to the semifinals, which took place at Hofstra University. Long Beach put up a good fight, but then unfortunately lost to Massapequa. The girls volleyball team capped off a good season as well. They made it to the quarterfinals, but couldn't move on to the next round as they lost to Southside. The girls tennis team finished their season with a 500 record. They finished at 4th place in the big conference. The boys soccer team finished their season with a record of 5-7-2. They capped off their last game as they beat Westbury with a score of 5-0. The Long Beach football team had one of their best seasons in a while. They finished in the conference in 4th place and had a record of 5 wins and 2 losses. They had a good run in the playoffs, but unfortunately ended up losing to Cary with a close score of 26-12. The Long Beach boys badminton team finished with a record of 12 wins and 2 losses, as they finish second place in the County standings.
All right, let's give it up for Justin. And we look forward to the winter events. Now let's give it up for Michelle from All Creatures. And where's Rocco? Let's bring Rocco in.
Hey, Rocco, come here.
He's going to jump out.
And one thing about, we love all our sponsors, and we support all our sponsors. When my dog, Chloe, my 9-pound toy poodle needed her teeth cleaned, the only place we could think of doing it was All Creatures. So, Michelle, welcome to the show, and what do you have cooking here at All Creatures?
Thank you, Howie. We have a lot of cooking at All Creatures. One of the big things that we're doing now is we know there's a lot of people in this community that are in need, and there are a lot of outreach programs that are giving, having food drives around the holidays. But what we know is that these people have no money to feed themselves. They especially don't have money to feed their pets. So we are having a food drive from now and through to the end of December. We're taking anybody who wants to give us food, pet leashes, kitty litter, you name it, anything that's available for dogs or cats and birds in their own fresh wrappers. And we're going to be delivering it to the soup kitchens. The Catholic school has some kind of outreach program. And we're going to give all our food that we can to the needy. We're looking into, we spoke to the Wounded Warriors, Long Beach Waterfront Warriors, and they're also interested in us maybe even sending food overseas to the canine unions. So if anybody's interested, if they are willing to give any type of donations, drop it off at All Creatures, 733 West Park Avenue. We'll be very happy to take it, and we know there's so many people that would love it. And thank you to all who are giving their most generous donations. We love you all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Wendy. And now let's bring on Rick Hoffman and Sean Schaefer from the West End Neighbors Association. First of all, Rick, welcome to the show, and I see you're a little bandaged up there, but you do a great job with the West End Neighbors Association, staying on top of all the important issues on the West End. But right now, first of all, welcome to the show, but secondly, what's going on in the West End right now?
Thank you very much, Howie. Right now, I'm really happy to say that the West End, in conjunction with the City of Long Beach, also the Chamber of Commerce, is working to bring a lot of projects into the West End. And with me tonight is the president of the newly formed West End Business Association, our famous litigator, Sean Schaefer. And if I may, I'd like Sean to say a few words about the organization, and I think he has a pretty good announcement to make tonight.
All right, let's get it. All right, Sean Schaefer!
Thank you, Howie. Thanks, Rick. The West End, the Historic West End Business Association, is just what it sounds like. It's made up of all the businesses and merchants down the West End of Long Beach who have gathered together to form this organization to help work in conjunction with the West End Neighbors, Rick Hoffman, president of West End Neighbors, to help beautify the West End, make it a place to bring people to, a destination place, not just in the summertime, but also in the wintertime. The historic West End business owners, along with the West End neighbors, the Walks Association president, Jamie Lynch, the City of Long Beach, Denise Ford, and the Ancient Order Hibernians have all worked together to get holiday lighting down the West End of Long Beach. And by tomorrow, that project should be completed, where we've got commercial lighting that will be running all the way down the West End of Long Beach from New York Avenue to Nevada. So we're all pretty excited about that. It's the first time in the history of Long Beach that such a project has been undertaken. And it's, again, part of a group effort to help beautify the West End of Long Beach. The West End neighbors, the Walks Association, the West End business owners, as I mentioned, have all worked hand in hand and tirelessly to make this effort come to fruition. And we're very proud of it. And I think the city of Long Beach is a better place for it.
Excellent. Rick, what are some of the important issues on the agenda as we head into 2012 for the West End neighbors?
Well, I think I just want to reiterate something that Sean said. You know, it was a cooperative effort with a lot of people involved to make this project come to fruition, like you said. And that's what it's all about. You know, you reach across and get everybody on board, sit at the table, you know, whether it's at a city level, whatever it is, to make things happen. And we're very proud that we actually got it done. And we're going to have a very festive holiday season. As for the West End Neighbors Civic Association, we continue our quest. We've always had one goal. For the 4 years I've been involved, it's for the betterment of the community. You know, there's a bunch of projects, like we talk about beautification, safety, quality of life, you know, issues that our residents day-to-day deal with. And what we do is listen to the issues, and we're looking for solutions. Everybody knows the problems in this town. They've been around for 40, 50 years. You know, our goal is to come up with solutions, try and get a project that we can, you know, satisfy those issues. And, you know, that's our goal right from the start, and we continue to do that. We reach out to, you know, we forged a great working relationship with the previous administration and the council members. They, you know, they were willing to work with us, and we went hand in hand to make things happen. And that's what, you know, that's what we need. And we're looking forward to the new administration that's coming in. Congratulations again to Len Torres, Fran Adelson, and Scott Mandel. You know, sometimes fresh blood means fresh ideas and some change in the wind, but we're all hoping that together we can make things happen, not only in the West End. We always look at projects that we call them pilot programs, and if they work, they can be, you know, you could work them into the rest of the city where necessary. If they don't work, okay, you take it away, but at least we tried. You know, that's the thing. I really detest not making a decision and not trying to put something to work. You know, what do we gain by that? Nothing. If you don't try, you're never going to succeed. So I'm really looking forward to 2012.
A big issue that I got to ask you about, both you guys, is that the latest about Quiksilver is they're committed to coming back to New York, but they haven't committed to coming back to Long Beach. So I have a two-part question. Number one, what do you think the economic impact of Quiksilver was last year, and how important is it to have Quiksilver back in Long Beach next summer?
Okay, your first question about the economic impact. There is no doubt that when the city made it a family-friendly event and was not selling alcohol at the site, it made people after the event circulate into our city. So, you know, without the added stuff of the, you know, the festival events and the skateboarding event, we had record crowds, all right? And those people, a lot of them went into our city and filtered their way down to the West End, and there was a positive impact in our city, and revenue was generated. My personal opinion is that it's huge to have Quiksilver come back to Long Beach. You know, we had that storm. All right, Mother Nature threw a wrench into it. Everybody was upset about not having the festival and whatnot. The decision was finally made to have the surf tournament. That's the key element to this whole event. And it was one of the best surf tournaments they've ever had. Quiksilver made record revenue from the sales of their product. 3 days in a row set the record from the previous day. All right, they surely want to come back here. They loved the town. The surfers loved the town. It's the place to be. You know, they talk about other venues, and naturally they're going to look at them, you know, and entertain those ideas. But I think that Quiksilver belongs here. I think that it's just when you look at it through and through. And when you look back to this year's event, we didn't know. There were so many unknown variables going into that thing. And personally, I felt that storm took away a lot of that, you know, those unknown elements by not having those festival events, because we didn't know what kind of crowds were coming in, whether we could actually handle those crowds. Now we have a platform from which to build on and make it bigger and better each year. All right, you set your goals at a certain, you know, amount of people or whatnot, but you have to have a starting point. And Mother Nature, although everybody, you know, was grousing about it, actually, in my opinion, helped us and the city out, because we handled what we had. And like I said, the last day of that tournament was a record crowd. It had to be at least 10,000. You know, that's a big crowd. And it worked well. And the event during the week, it wasn't major traffic issues. So we learned from that. So in my opinion, Quicksilver will want to come back here, you know, provided that it all works out financially or whatever the agreement is with the city. But, you know, I think that it's phenomenal. You know, I look forward to seeing those guys. You know, they also have a foundation, the Quicksilver Foundation, that it was great. I was dealing with those guys, the city was dealing with those guys, where they bring youths from different areas into the area where the tournament is. I mean, the surf tournament is. And they pick a project, and with Long Beach, the athletes from the surf team, their kids that they brought in, it was a great day. We tidied up, the park right outside off the boardwalk. And it was nice, you know, they constantly want to give back to the community. You know, they have a budget, they look for a project, they foot the bill. You know, they want to be ingratiated in our community. They want to be part of it. And, you know, I think it was a major success all in all last year. And like I said, you build off it a little bit more, there is no reason why they wouldn't want to come here. And of course, Mother Nature did help us with the storm off the Carolina coast,
okay,
which is what you need.
Great waves.
Yes, indeed. Thank you.
All right. All right, Sean, you know, one of the topics that I found the most overrated topic in Long Beach, when you offered me this, the law office, which we love, the conference room, people said, you can never find a parking spot in the West End. Totally overrated. There's plenty of parking in the West End. Never have a problem getting a spot. So is that true, overrated parking in the West End? But more importantly, Sean, as coach of the Bulldogs, you guys had a great run. So let's have a end of the year recap on the Long Beach Bulldogs.
Yeah, Cal, you're right. It was a great run. We had a couple of teams make it to the playoff games. Our 12-year-olds made it to the B Division playoffs. Our 9-year-olds made it. Won the B Division playoffs to play in the B Division championships game. Unfortunately, lost to Uniondale. And the 10-year-old team that I'm involved in, we made it to the eight bracket championships. First time the Bulldog team has made it that far. Good game, tough loss to Mineola. A fantastic season. A couple of great games down the end of the stretch to beat Garden City. Two out of 3 weeks, and Uniondale, another tough team. So it was a phenomenal season. The Bulldog program is growing every year. More and more children get involved in it. It's a fantastic football program, part of the Nassau County Youth Football League. Headed by guys like Paul Monzone and Gary Brown and Dennis Donahue. Great coaches, dedicate a lot of time. Kids are fantastic. It's a wonderful experience. This year has been phenomenal. And already looking forward to next year. Thanks.
All right, let's give it up for Rick Hoffman and Sean Schaefer.
All right.
Coming up after the break, the most dramatic rescue in Long Beach Fire Department history. We'll meet all the players after the break. Coming to you live from Long Beach's number one hair salon, the 5-Star Salon, right here in beautiful Lido. I am Halftime Alley, broadcasting on the beach from Long Island's first and oldest radio station, 1240 AM.